So we have discussed various aspects, various important features of Microsoft Word. Now let us see those functions which are still remaining in this home ribbon. So we are taking 2016 MS Word, but most of the functions or the formatting options are available in the previous versions also. So just the places may be different, but the things remain same. So let us write something that we are say learning Word, MS Word. Now you might be amazed that how my normal, if you write, it should be Calibri and some basic font and some basic the size of the font, but this has come in a different color. How did we get it? And this is because of this. This is called as, let me tell you first what this stands for. This is text effect and typography. So you can change the text effect and typography by this. Any word can be changed, or whole word can also be changed. Let me change first the other word with some other style, this with some other style. So this is the style. You can also change the outline with some color. You can also give some shading as it is given. You can also glow it like this. Say I'm glowing it. Or you can also give the number style, because the number style, how you need to write, these are different number style. 1, 2, 3, 3 is coming as a subscript or a superscript that you can give. You have ligatures also, the way you want to give, and these are stylistics, different sets which you can take. So I would encourage you to just try all these, which suits your application, which suits your the document, right? So these are all the possibilities that you can use. So this is all about the text effects and typography. Now let me take you back to the basic. Let me remove all the formatting. Okay, now I want to increase the font size. I can increase from here, but that will be quite tedious. Why not to do from here? This is increase font size. You can always use Control plus N, the greater than simultaneously keys. Now I'm increasing the size. Now I'm decreasing the size. Increasing the size, decreasing the size. Right? Now this, the content, I want to make it bold. I want to make it thick. So let me just do it bold. I want the content to make italic, it would be italic. I want to underline all the content, I can use U. So this is bold, italic, underline. And at any point, you can just change the, you don't want to make it this learning as, you don't want to make it italic. You don't either want it to be underlined. So you can just remove the underline. So this is how you can use the bold, italic and underline. Now what is this strike through? Sometimes what happens, some friend come to you and he says, I've written a document, now I want you to just proofread it. So when you proofread it, you find some problem and you say how to give it back to him, because you cannot sit with him and tell everything to be corrected, because you don't want to waste your time also. For that you can use strike through. So let me just remove the formatting, and I can just, or you can just strike through, make it as word red. So when he sees this document, he understands that there is a problem in this word and it is being striked through. So that is why this is being used. And other ways also you can use it, depends on totally upon your application and work. Now you want to do something called X square, but how to do it? X2, you want to do it X square. How to make it? Let me make X as black, right, first. So I can give, I'll show you about this color later. So this 2, this is the superscript. If I give 2, it will be X square. You can also always use the subscript with control, with shift and plus plus. This you have to use as the shortcut key. And if you want this 2 to be as a superscript, means near the foot, you can press this one. So now this will be X2 and 2 is lying below. So this is the superscript, this is the subscript. And I was telling about the change of color. So the, any text you can change, choose and you can change the color. Anyone, like this one I want to give green, this one I want to give say some other color, say red. So this is to change the color. This you will use to change the color. Now again, let me remove the formatting to, okay. Now this is a sentence. I want to make this sentence as a sentence case. This is a sentence case. Now I want to lowercase all the content. I can just go to this one and lowercase. This is showing me problem because W has to be, the first letter of any sentence has to be in English. It should be capital case. But we can always go to sentence case and now this is okay. Now there may be some cases I want this word to be emphasized and give it to, I want to just uppercase it. My colleague has typed something, but by incidentally or accidentally he has typed in as capital case. You can always make it as a smaller case. This is a smaller case. You can also toggle. See, if I toggle this, means all the uppercase will be changed to lowercase and vice versa. So W will be changed to small W and all other will be capitalized. This is your this toggle case. So these are all the options. It depends on your work, what you're going to choose for how you're going to work on it. And with this, I can show you that you can highlight also. So there is a highlighter. I want to highlight this word. So I can just go here, I can highlight it. So the way you read a book and highlight certain content, you can highlight here also. This is highlighter. Then we have something called as indent. You can always increase or decrease the indent. Means you can shift it on the right, you can shift it on the left. See, I am shifting it on the right, I am shifting it on the left. So this is also the possibility. One more thing is this one, which is our shading. You can change the color behind the selected text. You can change the color behind the paragraph or a table cell. So this applies to text, table, paragraph. While this, as we just saw, this applies to only text. So this is text highlighting the color, making your text pop up by highlighting it in a bright color. But this one, if I choose this one is basically theme colors. So you, when you give some certain color, they seem to be equivalent, but here is a difference. This is shading for text, paragraph and table cell, and this is only for text, right? Now I showed you this also. Now let me just remove all the this one formatting and make it as a sentence case. Now we are learning word, and now we are learning word. Let me take L here. So now there are certain changes. I can go to this one and I can sort the paragraph, say this one. Okay, now learning, we are learning, and if you say descending, the order will change. So see, the sentences, the paragraph, they will also change positions. If you want to descend or ascend, that means you want to order them. This is also a possibility. This is a great value addition. This is a very great value addition, that you can easily ascend or descend the content. Okay, so you can select also. This is the possibility of selection. You can select all, you can select certain objects. When you have table, when you have images, you can do that. This is also the way in which you can work. And as I just told you, you can select some content, you can cut it, you can paste it, you can copy it, you can paste it. This is a format painter, we have already discussed this. And this is how to make the content send the left, right, center, right? This is the whole document. So you can justify it using this one. Okay. This is also the possibility. You can give spaces between them. These are all the line spacing. I give 3. And you can give the bulleting. You can give the bulleting like 1, 2. And you can properly give them heading. That is the style you can give. You can find the content like this. I want to find your content as, say, word, say R, R, A, R, E. So it will find out wherever R exists. See, this is R, this is R. So there are two R's there. I want to replace now R with, say, some control H I'm pressing. R with change, say change. I press control H, now R will be changed with change, and I just want to match the cases, find one wholly, find whole words only, replace all. Okay. So this is all R, because there is no word called R which is smaller. So I will go again. Now I'll say match does not match the case, my match whole. So this two will be replaced. So these are all the options which are available here in the home tab. I hope you'll be taking all the content, writing it yourself, and you'll be applying all these so that you understand it better. So thank you so much. We'll be taking the other tabs shortly.